the salesman and not on the salesman. Wow. Majestic. Grandiose. Spectacular. Phenomenal. Ecstatic. All the grandiose words can be used for this. Even if there's not much, I mean, we don't have the wild bunch shootout. High noon, there's not too much going on. Literally, armed conflict, Saving Private Ryan. But still, in the psychological domain, that's a fabulous battle, and this film is outstanding. And it's good that I'm ending this day, I mean the notes for today, on this note, because this is one of the best films ever. It won the Academy Awards. Some said it was a bit political because Trump, Iran ban, travel ban. But then this is a giant. This is a god of cinema. He has under his belt Separation, phenomenal film. I need to note on this following days. About Elie Le Passé, a titan. The protagonists act in a play within the play, within the film. We have another narrative, Death of a Salesman, hence maybe probably the name, the title. We have Rana and Emma Etesami living in Iran without reference to political context, to Ayatollahs, to the regime, to impositions. I can't help but think when I see a film from Turkey or from Iran, I've started with Three Monkeys, another super chef d'oeuvre. And even there I was thinking in the context of something happening, sexual offense, a sexual misdemeanor, an affair, or they have honor killings. The attitude there is different, even if here we're talking sophisticated people. I wonder what the background, what the culture, what the influence is of the place they live in. And without going any further, the studies show that you're in trouble when your goals, your values are the opposite of what the others feel. I mean, I'm in this quandary, let's not give it catastrophic proportions, but in this shithole, because I don't share that. There are people here who don't want to pay. They have a company going and they want to pay less than a regular home like this, which is outrageous. In other parts they pay 10 times more, here they pay half of what. Anyway, so I'm just saying, I relate even more to the situation where I'm thinking these characters with their acting, their plays, are somehow isolated in this atollah. But maybe I'm speculating, because they may feel all right. They may feel like America is a great Satan and the Ayatollah is a holy man. Anyway, I'm just giving you some of my thinking when I see something like this. They're faced with a challenging traumatic experience, and the question is, will it be PTG, post-traumatic growth, or PTSD, post-traumatic stress disorder? The couple moves into an apartment. A woman had lived there and she was of ill repute. That's in a way funny. It's dramatic, it's a tragedy, it deals with tensions, with being on the edge of the precipice, or exactly in the sink, in in the abyss times, but this one, ill repute, they don't, if I remember well, they don't say prostitute. Again, they're also very careful with even saying the word. Saying the word will just make them sinners. I don't know. Again, that's how I thought about it. Seeing it again. So a client of that woman comes to the apartment without knowing she moved, and without the couple, Rana and Emma, knowing about her presence in the past. So something happens. Again, I'm confused here a little bit. But if I don't imagine it again, it's in part of the intent of the film to keep a view on this. What really happened? Did he really rape her, or just came in, saw her hair, and that's already a serious intrusion? By the way, I worked in a hospitality business, and I was astounded at one point to when working with Arab people, to see that there were pictures from a wedding, and I could see group pictures, but then pictures where some of them were only for women. And I asked, like, as it happened, I was with my girlfriend in the group at one point. What was it there? Naked? Was it erotic? No, you could see her hair. So even the hair, and of course, you know, the burqa, the thing, somehow go into different degrees, extremes, really, in defending the honor of the woman, the person, the woman who is not so cherished or treasured in some spaces. She's just kept as a, if not a slave, or anyway, a second class citizen. But here, it's different. It's part of the plot. Anyway, Emad is really angry with this. He wants a sort of a payback, not like in the Mel Gibson film, but still, it's tense. It's a psychological thriller. He finds the man. He's confronted with the man, and it makes for a fantastic face-off. It's not the American Western, and it's not pistols, but it's on the edge. It's phenomenal. A masterpiece. I need to say this again. One of the best films ever. It should be on any list of best 50 films.